Hello, this is Reverend Dr. Robert L. McKim, Sr., coming again to you on my teachings of the truth. Today is July 16th, 2013. There's some people out there on YouTube that have been criticizing me, putting me down about some of my videos. They just don't like the truth. Another thing too, they think I'm stupid and I'm lazy and I just don't want to work. Well, you know, that's far from it. You know, I do what I can do, not what they think I should be doing or what they think I can do, because evidently they didn't read and I didn't watch all my videos, especially the one where I'm showing my x-rays with my birth defects. But you know, they'll still probably say, oh, you're retarded, you're just retarded, you just don't want to work, you want to find some kind of excuse why you shouldn't be working, why you should be taking our tax money. You know, I worked for that money also. That is my Social Security that I worked for over 10 years. I worked. Where was you when I was delivering newspapers for 11 years in the snow and the rain? Before I even could drive a car, I had to do it on my bicycle. And it isn't just, throwing papers. That isn't a newspaper route. That is being lazy. Throwing the newspapers in someone's yard and letting them come out and get it and where it's all wet. That is being lazy. That's laziness. I wasn't lazy when I was delivering newspapers, and I'm not lazy now. I put the newspapers where the people wanted their newspapers, in their mailboxes, in between their doors, in their patios, where they wanted it to go so it stayed dry and clean so they could read it. That's where I put it. And I had a hilly part of town to deliver newspapers. I worked, and I worked hard. And even after I got my first job in November of 88, I worked hard doing that job too. I got sick with the flu, throwing up, weak. I could not get out of bed for a whole week. And when I went back to work with my excuse from my doctor, there was another employee, a guard that got fired supposedly for not picking up trash in the parking lot. He told him that wasn't his job description. He wasn't supposed to patrol the parking lot and go around picking up trash. So they let him go basically. And they hired two new guards to take his place. I asked why they was hiring two new guards. Well, my supervisor said, well, I just want to see which one will work out. And there was only one week on the desk. There's supposed to be 2 weeks, the week that you're working on and the following week of the schedule. It was only the week that I was working on. The following weeks wasn't on the desk yet. I asked her, where's the next week's schedule? Oh, I'm still working on it. Come Easter Sunday, foggy as all get out, I drive to work like I would normally had been scheduled to work. Got there, and guess what? The two new guards are there. I looked on the schedule. My name wasn't on the schedule anywhere. Long story short, I was threatened. And after finding out through filing for unemployment, my supervisor lied on me. She said I missed 16 days of work without a valid excuse. Hey, they paid me for every single day I was there that I did work except 6 days. You know what? People can lie cheat and steal all they want later on, because God protects me. Because my God protects me, here's a verse of scripture. Romans 12:19. Dear friends, never take revenge. Leave that to the righteous anger of God, for the scriptures say, I will take revenge, I will repay them back, saith the Lord. See, that's what I do. I just leave it up to God, and He pays people back that have hurt me. Later on, I saw them in the unemployment office, my supervisor and some other employees that was guards as well. I saw them standing in line waiting to file for unemployment while I was I was in there. I had to go in every so often, and I had to look for a job, look on the list of jobs, and I had to put my name in that I was looking for a job and things of that nature. I saw him there. I did what I had to do, and I left. So that's something I wanted to read. It's in Romans 12:19. You want to look it up. Somebody on YouTube has been coming down on me here lately. Of course, there's been several people. But this one person that has a picture of an angry bird for their picture. You know what? That tells me that they're a coward, because they really don't want to be seen who they really are. I have my picture on YouTube and my Facebook. I'm not ashamed of who I am. Evidently, they're ashamed of who they are, because they're the one that's complaining about my videos. They don't want me telling the truth. They don't want me telling people what's happened to me or what's been happening to me. The thing is, on one of the videos that they've been complaining about, it's about where I was talking about the sheriff had called me, wanted to know if I was soliciting money from somebody over the phone. I'm like, what? No, I wasn't soliciting money. I was just talking to somebody about my health problems. I was asking them about their great granddaughter and about her health problems. I didn't ask them for no money. I asked them to remember me in their prayers. Is that asking for money? I was just telling them about my struggles. People are so stupid. They can't even listen. They want to listen between the lines instead of listening to the words. It's like people want to quote a Bible verse all the time. Here, as soon as I find it. Yeah, in 2 Thessalonians 3:10, even while we were with you, we gave you this command. Those unwilling, now get that, unwilling to work will not get to eat. This is the New Living Translation is how this is how it's how this says it. But a lot of people want to quote the King James Version and says that if you don't work, you shouldn't eat. Well, they get this verse in scripture meaning even for the people who are bedridden, basically, that if they don't work, they shouldn't eat. Or somebody that's in a wheelchair that can't hold their head up straight, slobbering all over themselves, can't move their hands, that they're forced to go to the workshop, and all they just do is sit and do nothing because they can't do nothing. I know, I've seen it. I worked as a school bus driver for the developmental disabilities. I've seen it. I had to load people up like that and take them to the workshop, and they just sit there because they couldn't do nothing. But that is how our society is, because of stupid, retarded people. And when I mean retarded, to retard means to hinder, to hold back. Get it straight. It is you that is retarded, because you retard people from fulfilling their full potential in life. You know what? You're not supposed to be doing it as a true, honest Christian, as holding other Christians back. You're supposed to be lifting them up, encouraging them, not holding them back with your stupidness. This person on YouTube wanted me to talk about a verse that they quoted on YouTube. It's in Philippians 2, starting with 14. Do everything without complaining and arguing, so that no one can criticize you. Live clean, innocent lives as children of God, shining like bright stars in a world full of crooked and perverse people. But before that, if you was read before it, read before, and then you read after, and you get the true meaning here of what it's trying to say. Dear friends, you always follow my instructions. This is Paul talking. When I was with you, and now that I am always, it is even more important. Work hard to show the results of your salvation, obeying God with deep reverence and fear. No, nobody obeys God with a deep reverence and fear. Nobody fears God anymore. For God is working in you, giving you the desires and the power to do what pleases Him. Okay, see, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing what pleases God, okay? I'm not doing what pleases you stupid morons out there. And then it goes on with the 14. Do everything without complaining and arguing and so on and so forth here. Well, I read a little bit ago. And then 16 says, hold firmly to the word of life. Then on the day of Christ's return, I will be proud that I did not return. I did not run the race in vain. Excuse me. I did not run the race in vain. And that my work was not useless. But I will rejoice, even if I lose my life, pouring it out like a liquid offering to God, just like your faithful service is an offering to God. And I want all of you to share that joy. Yes, you should rejoice, and I will share your joy. You know, there's more going on here that Paul had wrote. But again, the kind of work that they are Paul had been really talking about and here and in the 2 Thessalonians 10. Is not the kind of work like labor. Otherwise it would say labor, okay? There's difference between labor and work. A lot of people get too mixed up. I can't labor like on a job like a lot of people think I should. I've had people say, well, you can sit down, you can drive, but with my back problem, sitting down, bouncing all around, bouncing, you know, in a vehicle, ouch, that hurts. My lower back, I can't do that. You know, I tell people I can't do that, but they still think I should do that. They think I should do something in order to make my own living. Let's see, my debts run around $1,000 a month. And if I wasn't on Medicare and Medicaid, then I would have to buy all my medication out of my own pocket. Granted, there might be some medication I still can get generic, but there is some medication out there that I can't get generic. And I'll show you my medications. And I want to show you people what my medications does to me. I know, right now. You don't care. Blah, 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 blah. You know, I've had enough of it myself, okay? God says, in the Bible, it says that I'm supposed to bless my enemies. Well, I'm doing this video in order to bless you, to teach you what really is the truth. I'm trying to teach you the truth that you guys are not getting. This is my potassium that I have to take. See? Potassium. It says right here. Here's one of my pills I take. And it's not, well, I guess it is a generic. It's coming out in generic now. But at first it wasn't a generic. But this pill here cost me $2. Well, it was costing me $2 when it was a regular name brand, $2 a month. Because my Medicare wouldn't pay for it, but my Medicaid paid for it. It's a special vitamin for neuropathy to try to get my nerves regenerated. This is my diabetic pills. My it's generic. It's my metformin. It's my diabetic medication that I have to have. And this is my high cholesterol medication. I also take a lot of over-the-counter medication to also help with my issues. Is my one bottle over there, dear, still, or did you throw it away? I take Nexium. Nexium by itself, if I was to go out and buy my Nexium, it would be around $140 a bottle. $140. I have to have Nexium. Plus, I have to take a Zantac at bedtime. Nexium in the day and Zantac at bedtime. Why? Because I just don't have heartburn, people. Because of having heartburn since I was 11 years old, it had ate away the lining of my esophagus. So my stomach lining has grown up into my esophagus, making me very high risk for esophagus cancer. Well, guess what, people? There's no cure. If I get esophagus cancer, maybe you'll have your wish, then I'll be dead. But let me tell you something, God's not done with me yet. Now here's something I want to show you. This is something I got to take for inflammation, swelling in my hands and also for my nerves. It's called Relafen. And right here on the bottle it says, may cause drowsiness. That's one bottle there that says that. Here's my Neurontin. Again, it says right here on the bottle, may cause dizziness or drowsiness. And here's my Xanaflex with a muscle relaxer. It says right here, may cause dizziness. Problem is, the may isn't, you know, the factor. The true factor is it does cause me to be sleepy. And Ultram, again, Ultram with my Ultram. It says right here, may cause drowsiness. There's four medications right there, people, that I take that causes me to be sleepy. Now, if I was to take really as prescribed during the day, then I would be sleepy during the day. Now, just at night, at bedtime, to help me rest and sleep. But also, during the day, if I was to take them during the day, then I'd be sleepy during the day. What kind of life is that? And what employer would hire me knowing that I gotta take all this medication for my back, for my arthritis in my hands, so they don't swell up when there's a low pressure? Yeah, my hands swell up, and my knuckles especially, they swell up, and they hurt. And my fingers swell up a little bit bigger than what they are now. And it's hard to move my hands when my hands swell up. So when it comes right down to it, I can't really do a job with my hands because of my arthritis in my hands. And I can't do a job because of my back or my legs or my feet. So the truth is, people, I'm not leaving YouTube. I'm not leaving Facebook just to please you. I am pleasing God. I'm going to teach the truth whether you like it or not. You can run me down, you can criticize me, you can say, I don't know my Bible. I know the Bible. I also know the Bible tells me to preach without ceasing. The Bible also says we're supposed to love one another, and our love will show others that we are disciples of Christ. And when you really love somebody, you will go out of your way to help them. There's another Bible verse I ran across. Also, as soon as I can get to it. Hang on a second here. If I remember where it was. I think it was here. Yeah, here we go. Here we go. In Romans 12, 13, it says, when God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. And then it goes on in 14, it says, bless those who persecute you. Don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Because it goes on and says, be happy with those who are happy, and keep and weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with each other. Don't be proud. To enjoy the company of ordinary people. And don't think you will know it all. Granted, I don't know it all. But I do have the wisdom to know that God's word, all throughout God's word, it's always about somebody helping somebody. Somebody giving to it till it hurts in order to get something that they needed. Like when the prophet went to the lady that didn't have, well, it was basically down to her last bread for her son and her to eat, and he said, God commanded you to give me what you have. Well, she did. She did, and then her cupboards and her vessels were running over for the rest of the drought. She had more than what she needed because she gave everything she had to the point of dying. Jesus gave his life. His blood. He died for us. How many out there would die for me? Let me tell you something. When I was helping people, broke down in the winter time, or going to accidents in the winter time, and these big semis barreling down on you and basically almost losing control and almost hitting me. I put my life in danger to save other people's lives. What have you done except gripe and complain about what I'm not, what you think I'm not doing or I should be doing? It is you people who are doing the griping and complaining. Now, if I don't start seeing some positive comments on my YouTube pages, I'm going to block you. Figured out how to do that now. I'm going to block you. After I save what you've commented on, because I'm writing a book about how people are, how people basically don't care anymore. I've noticed a gradual decline from 1990 on down through. Especially, it seems like it's gotten worse after 2000. Everybody kept saying, oh, Y2K, Y2K is going to, you know, shut down all the computers. But Y2K was actually Satan's way of entering into people's hearts and to people's minds. It is people's hearts and people's minds that are shutting down. Well, I think I've said enough now for a little over 30 minutes. So, have a blessed day.